Hazy day here, but the temperature's right, so the hogs are getting hot. They're gonna go to bed, and that's key if you're still hunting and spearing. I mean, they tell them what's going on here, Billy.
Well, the hogs are in there laying down in the woods, and you know, you're just gonna have to be real quiet and try to sneak up on them. While they sleep.
We had a good rain last night. Which is going to be helpful because we can still hunt in there quiet. And Ryan, back from Iraq and Afghanistan, he's been still hunting a lot lately with an AR-15, or what was your weapon of choice?
Over there?
Yeah.
AR-15.
AR-15.
War joy.
War joy.
So with a sharp spear, I head out in hopes of killing one of the many monster boars that live throughout the forest of Hog Wild Adventures. It's a cattle operation, but the cattle feeders draw hogs for miles. There's so many that they seem easy to kill, unless you're trying to do it with a spear.
Nice throw.
Yeah, went good and straight that time.
For a leper. Well, here we are out here at Billy's once again at Hog Wild Adventures. And as you've seen, I basically failed the first day, Billy.
It's all right. Keep it up, buddy.
Hey, that's spear hunting, though. You got to get them close if you want to spear them.
Exactly.
Ryan's over here. This is his first spear hunt. We tested out the broadhead last night, did we not?
We did. The broadhead, it did what it's designed to do. I mean, it penetrated both sides of the hog.
Holy cow. This guy's lucky as they get. He comes to Illinois, first day he still hunts, he goes out, kills a big whitetail. He comes down here, Billy. You've had, what, hundreds of hunters here on this place. First day in the tree stand, he's sitting up with Zach. They're experimenting with the new, what walks out? But a 350-pound boar. Crazy. One of the biggest pigs shot this year, but this place is loaded with big boars, and what a great place to come, especially for spear hunters.
Right. You got plenty of opportunities.
Yeah.
Plenty of opportunities, man.
Yeah.
Really do.
So we got a nice place to stay here. There's a stripper pole inside that Billy uses, and you know, I try to stay outside when all that's going on, but normally never hunts when you got clients.
Nope.
But Billy is a killer and a cat fisherman that goes from way back. He's a bragger too. He likes to send me pictures of his big cats because I like to catfish like Billy does.
Right.
But this week you're gonna hunt with us a little bit. You promise?
Yes, I'll do it.
All right. So we're gonna get the spear in his hands. We'll see how Billy does.
Just don't be mad at me if I do it.
Well, you probably won't air it if you get lucky. But,
probably not.
You know, we gotta
probably
keep me
not.
Looking.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. We'll make you look good anyway.
How you doing, Ryan? Are you ready?
Ready to go.
So with a little good advice from Billy, I headed back into the woods with two sharp spears. My stealthy stalk and hawk-like eyes have quickly picked up on a big boar. He's sound asleep beside a tree just ahead. I'm moving in for the kill now. And sure enough, he's sound asleep. Been taking a dirt nap for probably 2 weeks now. Now, spearing a hog is not nearly as easy as you might think. Zach, my cameraman, has gotten really close. But right when you think you got him, well, you know the rest of the story. Their senses are unlike most. They can hear and smell the slightest thing. Decided to get high in the trees. He's set corn down below him, and with so many hogs in the area, it's just a matter of time before one of them smells the corn and comes to the bait. And it wasn't long before a big herd of hogs came rambling through the woods. Unfortunately, they're upwind of the bait and haven't picked up on its odor. There's no big boars in the bunch, but there's plenty of fat butter balls that we'll love to have back at camp.
Nothing cuter than a baby pig. When I was a kid, my dad brought me home a baby pig. And I just loved that little pig. He would lay on the floor with me in the house and watch TV and cuddle up beside me when he got a little bigger even. Finally, he started pooping on mom's floor and she made me take him outside. And so I raised that pig, and every day I'd have to go out before school and feed him corn. And one day I came home from school and the pig wasn't in the barn. I said, "Dad, what happened to the pig?" And he said, "Well, we sold the pig." And I got all sad, and then he gave me $80. That's what I got for the pig. Then I was happy again. I went and bought some shotgun shells to go duck hunting with that. And he never told me who he sold it to, but kind of glad he never. Anyway. We'll leave these little pigs alone. Go hunt for their big daddy.
Now, Billy was out playing Rambo himself while I was out telling stories about baby pigs. And he's found a herd of boars and sows. that have picked up on the smell of his bait. They've taken the bait, but Billy's patient. He's letting them get comfy with the bait before making the throw. It's a race to eat as much corn as you can before the rest of the herd gobbles it down. Finally, a big boar moves into position where Billy can make the throw. Kill and Billy's spear kill were quite impressive. There's only one guy left who hasn't killed, and I'm up next. Now, hunting at night is my favorite time for big boars. They seem to let their guard down a bit. And with a full moon, I set out with high hopes.
I want to find one sleeping. Cruise around in the woods, and then they find a thick brushy hole, brush pile, fallen tree, sometimes in a creek bottom. If you get lucky, sometimes you'll see where they've taken all the leaves and made a nest. Really, I'll kill one, it's just a matter of time.
My cameraman spotted him first. It's a big boar. And he appears to be asleep, tucked in against the brush. I'm moving in for the kill now.
He looked out ahead of him and saw the light. And now he is going to the light.
the very beginning, man has been a hunter. A piece of flint was made to fly.